From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Dive teams from the Maine Warden Service and the Maine State Police will resume their search in Waterville Wednesday for Ayla Reynolds. Investigators have not yet said where they plan on diving. State and Waterville Police are investigating the disappearance of the 21-month-old girl from her father's home back on December 17th. A $30,000 reward has been offered for information on her whereabouts. The Portland man convicted of murder and arson in the death of his girlfriend appealed his case to the state's highest court on Tuesday. Chad Gurney is in prison serving his sentence for killing 18-year-old Zoe Sarnacki and then setting her body on fire. His defense attorney told justices that Gurney wasn't criminally responsible and said there is no proof that he visited websites with information about decapitation before the killing. Prosecutors told the court that Gurney told friends and police after the crime that he knew what he was doing and he knew that it was wrong.
It suggested to him a motive. Given what Zoe had said to him in the days before the murder, he was an angry man. And perhaps that video gave him the idea to do exactly what he did.
There was absolutely no proof that he actually saw the video or even visited the website. It was a detective after the fact trying to backtrack and figure out where the reference in the deleted space on the computer may have come from. There's nothing to indicate that Mr. Gurney even saw the reference as it existed.
Gurney received a 60-year sentence, and his attorney says he is currently on medication. A new medical marijuana dispensary in Hollowell is now open for business. The nonprofit group that runs it, Wellness Connection of Maine, gave folks in the community a look inside during an open house on Tuesday. Patients will have access to services like acupuncture, massage, and personal counseling free of charge. There is no limit to the number of patients that the dispensary can treat. Medical marijuana dispensaries operate within the boundaries of state law, but they are violating federal law, something staff at the Hollowell dispensary say they are aware of.
We are following state law to the letter. We're very transparent with the state, and we have faith that those two foci or goals of ours, to focus on patients, to follow the state law in every respect, will be helpful to us.
To become a patient at a state-run medical marijuana dispensary, you either need a doctor's recommendation or a state-issued medical marijuana ID card and a photo ID. Other dispensaries are expected to open soon in Brewer and in Portland. Well, the Maine Agricultural Trade Show kicked off Tuesday in Augusta. This is the 71st year for the three-day show at the Civic Center. It aims to be educational by providing lectures, demonstrations, and workshops. Both farmers and non-farmers can learn from the different vendors. The show is hosted by the Department of Agriculture. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.